Let's get a little practice solving equations. Let's consider the equation 1/4 x plus 3/8 is equal to 2. One technique that we have for solving equations that involve fractional coefficients is to multiply both sides of the equation by a common denominator. So the LCD for this equation, the LCD for the equation would be 8. So what I'm going to do is multiply both sides of the equation by 8. Applying the distributive property, I would have 8 times 1/4 x plus 8 times 3/8 is equal to, and on the right hand side, 2 times 8 is 16. 8 times 1/4 x, well, let's remember that 8 is really an 8 over 1. And we can then reduce between the 8 and the 4, leaving a 2 and a 1. Then multiplying across, we have 2 times 1 times x, so that's 2x plus. And again, I'll think of this 8 as an 8 over 1. And then we see that we can reduce between these 8s, leaving 1 and 1. And so then we have 1 times 3, which is 3. So we now have 2x plus 3 equals 16. Now from here, subtracting 3 from both sides yields 2x equals 13. And dividing by 2, x is equal to 13 halves. Or if you want a decimal number, 6.5. Moving on to the second equation. 2/5 times the quantity x plus 4 is equal to 7/10 x minus 5. First, let's apply the distributive property to remove the quantity on the left-hand side. So we would have 2/5 times x plus 2/5 times 4 is still equal to 7/10 x minus 5. Simplifying yields 2/5 x. And 2/5 times 4, remembering that 4 is a 4 over 1, and multiplying across, we would have 8/5. 7/10 x minus 5. Now, similar to the previous exercise, let's find an LCD for the equation. Our denominators are 5 and 10, so the LCD is 10. Multiplying through both sides of the equation by the LCD, which is 10. And applying the distributive property, I'll think of that 10 immediately as a 10 over 1. So I have 10 over 1 by 2/5 x plus 10 over 1 by 8/5 is equal to 10 over 1 by 7/10 x minus 10 times 5. Reducing appropriately, this 10 and 5 yields a 2 and a 1. This 10 and 5 yields a 2 and a 1. And this 10 and 10 yields a 1 and a 1. Simplifying, 4x plus 16 is equal to 7x minus 50. Solving this linear equation, I'll subtract 7x from both sides and subtract 16 from both sides. So I'd like to move all the variable terms to one side of the equation and non-variable terms to the other. Negative 3x is equal to negative 66. Dividing through by negative 3 to isolate the variable, x is equal to 22. Six p minus 3 times the quantity, 4.1 p plus 2, is equal to 3p plus 13.2. First, let's simplify the left-hand side. Applying the distributive property, we would have 6p minus 3 times 4.1p, that would be a minus 12.3p, minus 3 times a positive 2, minus 6 is equal to 3p plus 13.2. Simplifying the left-hand side further, we have some common, or I should say like terms. 6p minus 12.3p is negative 6.3p minus 6 is equal to 3p plus 13.2. Bringing variable terms to the left, I'll subtract 3p. And non-variable terms to the right, I will add 6p. I'm sorry, just 6 to both sides. Negative 6.3p minus 3p, that's negative 9.3p. Right-hand side, I've got 13.2 plus 6, so that's a 19.2. And to isolate the variable, we'll divide through by negative 9.3. And at this point, let's use a calculator to simplify this expression. So p would equal 19.2 divided by negative 9.3. Negative 2.06, and let's round that appropriately. Let's take it out to the nearest thousandth, so negative 2.065. And we should really get rid of the equal sign because that wasn't an exact number. Replace it with an approximately equal to.